Ready, let's rock and roll here. Let me get a sip of this coffee before we get going. Of course, brother, I know you want, I mean, I do want it, man. I'm a little thirsty for this one. Everyone, thank y'all so much for being here too, man, on your Saturday. I hope all you gals and girls are doing great out there. Or it could be Sunday for you already. I know it's getting later. I know it's getting later for a few. All right, guys. Let's take this Frost Night. Let's see what is happening here. And what you got to do is, you just got to do the hands waving to everybody. Kaibutt's hugging with that tsunami. If you come in top three, I'll give it. No, I don't want you to do that. Even if I come in top three, McSteezy, no, sir. You have done already more than enough, man. Do not worry about that for real. No, sir. I appreciate it, but no, sir. Too bad, so sad. No. We're opening the Ford up, guys. Wide open. Now I'm going to play for real, but no. Oh, the other Frost Knight pair, but we got a Light Blade. We'll go ahead and grab that Light Blade. Foxy, are you playing Knights Foxy? Are you playing Knights Foxy? He's not yet. Okay, good. I want to try to do some Glacial Knight practice. It's something I've wanted to do, but I haven't done it yet. So we'll see if I can get Glacial Knight going on this game. Who knows? Light Blade Knight dropping the blade on top of the treant right now. It is not ricocheting, though. Everyone is so separated. Frost Knight about to drop that snowball. There it is. Looking good. And we'll take the treants down. Bum, bum, bitty, bum, bum, bitty, bitty. We got a Frantic Mask already. So let's just go ahead and take this Frantic Mask because it is going to be very, very good on Light Blade Knight. Desperate Doctor, don't mind if we do. This is coming right along, guys. This is already a good Glacial Knight start. Let's see if we can make the dream happen. What's Crow got? Crow will play some Frost Knights as well. I know Crow. I know that Frost Knight carry. I've seen it. Lightblade Knight ricocheting around. Xena Warrior Princess going to be our carry right here, doing a good bit of damage. We got Desperate Doctor, Frost Knight dropping the damage down as well. And let's see what everyone bought here, too. Let's see what this lobby's looking like. We got Beast Warrior on Sajax. We got some Druid Witcher up there for Stratega. Maybe going Beast, maybe going Feather. Who knows? Pete Dog got the options for Beast and Feather open. Very good player at both, like I've already talked about. We'll grab both of these as well. And I think we're okay right here, guys. I think we're sitting pretty. As good as we can be. Let's see the rest of the lobby again. Let's grab this Unicorn, too. We got almost all that roll right there. Crow holding a bunny, Urgisus Ranger, and a Water Spirit. We have Kaibutz right now who is open fording. Maybe going Warriors from Kaibutz. I don't know. And we get Kaibutz first, baby. I'm feeling confident with this win. Priestess tanking as much as possible, but she is surrounded by the Knights of the Round Table, and we'll take him down there. Hey, I like an easy first win. I'll give it to Kaibutz. I'm down with it. We got a few people down here, too. GG has a 2 Cave Clan with a 2-star Witcher. Actually, pretty good right off the bat there. Lava Shaman and Sword. And then we have Foxy, who's in Cave Clan Warrior right now. So there might be a couple of Warriors this game. We'll have to wait and see. Another Lightblade Knight, when I can close this out, is looking really good. And a Fortune Teller, too. We've already got four. We've already got four of our Glacial. I was trying to say Troll because I was thinking about Dota. Getting away from the Dota names, though, guys. We got to use the auto chess names. We got to respect the game that we're in. So we'll start using our auto chess names. Who are we going to get? We got two Light Blades in. We do have Knight bonus because we have a Frost Knight in right now. But we're not super strong. We're getting Crow right now. Crow's coming out with that Water Spirit. Maybe Water Spirit Divinity this game. But maybe he goes Divinity Whisperseer. I should have done Divinity Whisperseer this game instead of Glacial Knights. I don't want to take it from Crow, though. We are getting murked right now from the Desperate Doctor, the Shining Archer, and the Water Spirit takes us down there. Thanks for the game, guys. I'm tired. Just want to watch. Garu, you are just fine, man. Never feel obligated to play, Garu. Thank you for even playing that game, man. Thank you. You kick your feet back, pull your hair up, and you relax for me, and just don't worry about anything, okay? Thank you so much for playing, Garu. All right, so here's what we're going to do. We'll take him out. We will leave in our Lightblade Knight and our Hell Knight now, and we'll try to get over into four Glacials real fast. I think I'll grab another coffee. You know, McSteezy, go grab another coffee. I'm sipping on another coffee right now, brother. I hear you, man. I love this GG name with the mouth. It looks like eyes. So we got GG right now, actually. Two-star Taboo Witcher burns the mana away from our Hell Knight. We Lava Shaman's ult goes off, but guess what? You can't silence the Lightblade Knight. She has a passive snipes come down from the Dwarf Sniper onto the Desperate Doctor and Lightblade. Lightblade is still cleaving away, though, baby. And we'll take that round away. Who's GG, guys? Oh, my internet is alive. It's alive. It's alive. We get nothing here, so let's go ahead. Not the actual nothing. Nothing's asleep right now. We get no rolls. We'll go ahead and roll up, and what we're going to do is we're going to put in, take Hell Knight out, and we're going to put our Glacials in. And we do this because now we have four Glacial bonus, which is going to give our Lightblade Knight 40% attack speed. GG is my friend. He said hello. Hello, GG. He's more than welcome in here too, say Jax. I haven't seen GG, so I didn't want to miss anybody. He's just fine. Thank you for bringing your friend in here, man. We've got the Foxy Warriors against us. Has Beast and Cave Clan in there as well. Fortune Teller drops his shield on himself, tanking away for us. While Lightblade Knight is cleaving away as much damage as possible. I don't know if we have enough to take this. We do end up with a Penguin on the bottom side. One-star sword is spinning to win. And yeah, we will survive this. Foxy's scrappy though, guys. Foxy's a little scrappy there. Evil Knight. Ooh, baby. We're getting all the knights we need. We've gotten most of the glacials we need. High rolling a Troll Berserker would be very, very nice, though. Or, for some reason, a Sacred Lancer comes down. You know we're not going to argue. We got Pete Dog on the top as well with 99 health. Pete Dog has Feathered and Hunter happening right now on the bench. And it looks like he's going to go Feather Hunter. We'll wait and see still. It's still early. But it's looking like Feather Hunter instead of Beast out of Pete Dog. We are going against Ortega right now, who has some Feathered happening. Maybe going Beast. What's the name of the track? This is... the name of the band is Tribal Seeds, and the song's name is Vampire. Anytime, Garu. Anytime, man. Once again, thanks for being here. Thank all y'all, guys. Thank y'all so much for hanging out, for playing these games, too. Us getting to have a little bit of a good time, get to experiment, and not have to worry about losing rank or anything doing it. And get some very, very, very good players in here to play against, too. All right, so four knights takes us up 20%, but we lose 40% attack speed. So I don't think we do that. Let's go ahead and level, and we'll put the Hell Knight back in right now. Love these kinds of games. Great practice for me personally, even just to watch. Yes, McSteezy, 100%, man. Very great practice to play in, but you can learn a ton just from watching. Because it does get a little crazy sometimes. We got Sajax against us, who is going Warrior as well. Looks like has a Flame Wizard back here, though. Might end up going into Wizards. We get the stun down from Heavenly Bomber. Uppercut from Tusk comes down, but our Fortune Teller has his shield up. And this Lightblade Knight, man, Lightblade Knight is so good to start early. Holy moly, she is so good. I don't build Knights enough, guys. I don't build Knights enough, honestly. Where would my Beast knowledge be without you? Anything I can do to help, McSteezy. Don't worry about that, man. I wouldn't have any of the knowledge about the auto chess community teaching me along the way, man. I'm still, like I said, I'm not a baby anymore. I'm an adolescent. I try to be good, but I got them growing pains and that teen angst. But man, there's been so many people. Stupid, no priest again. I'm sorry. I have the fortune teller priest, Crow. I'm sorry. But this is the Auto Chess community has taught me basically everything I know, McSteezy, from just coming in here and being like, what are you doing, dummy? That's not what you're supposed to do here. I'm like, I you're right, guys. I'm sorry. I've learned so much. That's how I was able to that dragon game. I don't ever play dragons earlier. We got that third place because of Garfit having coached me through a dragon game before, having watched people playing dragons like Wills and stuff. So it's it really is. We need this. A Holy Spirit Lance on Lightblade Knight is redonkulous. So we go ahead and grab that item right there. It is the Magicka Staff and the Broken Sword together that make it. So we'll grab it. We'll put it together. Let it rock and roll. Yeah, so it's just sharing of knowledge. It's the brain trust. The brain trust of the Auto Chess community. I have all the basics. I need no priest. Nah, I need the divinity one. Got you. I don't have that, Crow. I'm sorry. I don't have the goddess priestess. I hope you get it. Are you going Whisper Seer in your build for this, Crow? Because I would love to see that. It's going to probably drop damage on me, but I would love to see it. I'm not even going to lie to you. All right, so we got a Frantic Mask and a Black Ice Lance right now. Pete Dog has 6 Feather already, is holding a Lightblade Knight. We have the Ricochets going through. Fortune Teller goes down. I don't even think his shield went off. Have it 2-star at the moment. Crow, you're speaking my language. I want to see this thing. The Lightblade Knight Force doing a lot of damage. Stun comes down from the Shining Archer. The Lightblade's dead. It's Desperate Doctor against the Feather World. Takes down the Bunny. Takes down the Snowman. And Desperate Doctor. I'm excited to be. I can't wait to see that Bill Crow. And don't be upset if I use it after this game either. I might use it. Let's see. Let me go look at something here too. Let's see what Crow's got going on. He is. He has Water Spirit. He's got Warp and Whisper. And there is the Goddess. So he can get the Divinity Bows going now. Get some cooldown reduction happening there. Let's see what everyone else is doing too here. Lightblade Knight with some good items is pretty dumb early though, guys. I will just put that out there. All right, we got Sajax's Warriors. 2-star God of War is very, very big. Do we need to pause this for GG? Did he disconnect? The Lightblade Knight is ricocheting around. We got a Penguin on the top side from our Defector. Big AoE came down from the 2-star God of War. Lightblade Knight is still trying to chop away. Is this Ragu? This is a gentleman called Conqueror. He's a YouTube reggae artist. He actually does have a song with Shaggy Garu. You're dead on the money for that. How many people have Witcher? Very good question. He sounds a lot like Shaggy, though. So we got 2 Witchers, right? Let's do this. Girl, this go deeper than physical attraction. I want to rock our Golly Knight over Hell Knight, guys. Because so many Witchers with Beast, with Feathered. We'll keep him just in case. But now we get a 4 Knight bonus. And we might stay away from Hell Knight just to keep away from Witchers taking away the Demon bonus. Anyway, our Garly Knight gets the AoE downward against Stratega, who has probably going Beast, but is in Feathered Hunter right now. Lightblade Knight is doing a ton of damage on this one-way avenue. Sometimes the volume's really low in my headphones, Garu. That's why I had to be like, wait, who is it? There we go. Now this is a gentleman named Conqueror. Woo, boy. How many of y'all gonna end up going Witcher here, guys? Stratega probably will. Stratega's going Beast, so he could probably go Fallen Witcher with Beast because he does have the Taboo Witcher 2-starred. And then we definitely know Pete Dog will. So, we'll wait. We'll wait on him. It is reggae. Yes, it is indeed. I do love some reggae, man. We got the GG against us right now. Has the Cave Clan, look like Warrior, just a lot of good 2-star units. Taboo Witcher on the front line, so it's good we took our Hell Knight out. Lightblade Knight ricocheting around. Xena is a monster, guys. Xena is a monster. I'm kind of liking Knights again. I haven't played Knights in so long. Efficiently, but Knight's Glacial is actually pretty easy to get online, but no one's griefing me right now either. Because y'all are scholars and gentlemen. Lord, everyone has Taboo. I know, Crow! That's why I had to get rid of Hell Knight, man. Oh, man, that's so, so good. We gotta take him. Level 8, this will give us Urgisus, and it'll give us a Warlock bonus. So we definitely need this high rolling. Soul Reaper right here, without a doubt. I'm just holding this unicorn too. I haven't looked to buy another unicorn. I haven't looked to buy any druids. I'm just holding her. She's just here. Everyone does have Taboo though, Crow. Without a doubt. We got the NWO Wolfpack against us. I didn't rearrange. That's okay. We have Night Shield protecting us a little bit. Lightblade Knight just ricocheting around, doing mega, mega damage right here. And we'll be able to drop it. I just don't listen to it much. Everything I remember is just Bar Marley. Even it was more. Yes, I understand that completely, Garu. I played in a reggae band for many years, so I kind of listen to a lot of it still, because it's just one of my faves, you know. But I completely understand, Garu. I hope you're enjoying it a little bit. I hope you're enjoying it. It's good music, man. Always has good messages. Everyone. In the reggae scene, normally trying to make the community and world better. What instrument is that? What instrument? In this song you're talking about? In the band. Oh, what instrument did I play? I played bass, Crowforge. I play bass. Been playing bass for, it's kind of crazy to even think about how long I've been playing bass, honestly, man. But I've been playing bass for, man, how long has it been? 19 years? 19 years that you play bass? Bass, I love bass. Dude, bass is amazing. Just get the groove, man. It's basically the soul of the band. I do guitar and bass. I've never learned to play guitar. I've always wanted to play Guitar Crow. That's one thing I have not do. Flea is a very good bassist, man. I'm sure you're a music guy. You even knew who Jonathan Young was. Do you know who Victor Wooten is, Crow? Have you ever heard Victor Wooten or seen him play? We are actually, guys, we're against Fox here right now, these Warriors, and this Lightblade Knight is just going crazy. We end up taking that round. Is Foxy DC, guys? We need to pause this for Foxy. Hey, Foxy, you still in here? I told you, I'm a little slow today, Crow. I'm sorry. Thank you for the help there, B. Bass is underrated for sure. I agree, McSteezy. It's, like I said, the guitar is the face of the band, but the bass is the soul, and the drums is the heartbeat. That's how I always look at it. There's Foxy. Yeah, Victor Wooten is ridiculous. Ridiculous, man. What he can do on a bass is, it's like he's playing a different instrument. He's so good at it. It's so stupid. Blows my mind. All right, we got Pete Dog coming out here with the feathered... Pete Dog is going feathered demon right now, has a fallen Witcherin. Lightblade Knight is trying to chunk away. He hasn't... Pete Dog's normally ahead druid-wise, and it looks like he's struggling with the Warpwoods a little bit. Does have a big Whisper Seer at 2 stars. Lightblade Knight still clearing out the Hunter's Forest, and we will take the round away from Pete Dog, who is strong. But Pete Dog is not nearly what he's going to be soon. So that was that could have gone really bad. If that normally Pete Dog, whenever I run into Pete Dog, he's got like 3-star druids on round 19. So it could be coming here very soon. No Warp Daddy at 2 stars even to be a big tank, which is really what allowed us to take that victory away. Got to keep the hustle, keep hustling, do it. Let the love in, come back to me. All right, so we got to do a little adjusting. Positioning hasn't been the best. We're keeping the knights further back so their shield can activate before they get in here and start fighting people. Could try to get 4 warlocks going on with this, but we might go for shaman too. Who knows? Actually, we should just go for shaman. Let's try 4 shaman with it, because we already got one with the Vector in here. If we don't see a Berserker or Sacred Lance, we got a big Kaibutz 9 warriors coming out. I thought he might do this with that open 4, and the 9 warriors has split us open, bent us over, and had its way with us. Holy moly, Kaibutz. Kaibutz open forwarder for that too, man. Rogue Guard already hit the 9, going hard. I did not like what I saw there. Somebody just go ahead and beat Kaibutz for me, please. Make this easier on us, guys. All right, we'll go ahead and get our Urg Assist and our Warlock bonus by putting in this Soul Reaper that we just somehow high rolled. If we lose, we'll drop one of these Unicorns and get that 50 Econ to keep our paper up, baby. We got to keep the paper up, right? Oh, we got Crowforge against us, it looks like it is. The Divinity Whisper Seer build right now. Forgot I started a game and tanked until round 5. Oh, McSteezy, I'm sorry, man. No Unicorn, 2-star, no 2-star Water Spirit, no Grim. Ugh. That is about as tough as it can be for Divinity, honestly. Got the source back there. We will take Crow out. Crow's going to live, though. We didn't do that much damage. We did a good bit. Too much fun in the stream. I don't mean to distract you, though. I don't want to take your elo away, McSteezy. You got to get King for me, man. You got to get King for me, baby. Yeah, see, that's really the problem with the Divinity. But you're doing fine with it, Crow, honestly. Just go ahead and try to get leveled up here and see if we're going Shaman or see if we're going Warlock in this build. It's okay. I mean, when it's online, though, if you can get that Whisper Seer 3-star and online early with that build, I bet you it slaps like crazy. You just have trees running amok. Trees running amok if you can get that online. That's why I want to play that build, Crow. I'm very interested in it. Good. I want you to get online, so I'm pulling for you to get this Grim Touch because I want to see it in action and I want to see it going hard. We'll go ahead and just take a second Frantic Mask, guys, and just stack that on top of our Lightblade Knight and just have her rocking and rolling, man. We need that on Garly. I had it round 12. Druid for Econ. Oh, I missed. I wasn't paying attention, Opstra. Thank you, though, man. I was totally not paying attention at all there. Let's do one roll. That was a good one roll. Ugh, Opstra, man. Sorry. I know exactly what you're talking about, man. I totally missed it. Getting on round 12, RNG gods. Man, I totally spaced out, wasn't even thinking about it. I told you, I'm just holding these unicorns right now. They're just here as trophies. We get Kaibutz as warriors again. We did two-star the Argali. He has the Mysterious Staff on him to heal up a little bit more. Our Lightblade Knight is murdered by this Rogar, though. The warriors are going hard in the paint right now, and that's going to be 16 damage on us. Somebody put Kaibutz out for us, please. Everyone end this problem real fast. There's a bounty on Kaibutz. Bounty on Kaibutz. Yeah, let's do it. As soon as I saw him, there was the Whisper Seer. So even though we got our Econ, we don't exactly make out, because we could have not taken that gold, got this Whisper Seer, start her up and sold her, so we would have got the gold either way, basically. No druid business. No druid business indeed, Garu. One more Whisper Seer for the hard way. I've got the Whisper Seer right here for you, Crowforge. I will send it to you. It's literally on my screen. I am looking at him as we speak. Man, what is the nine warriors from Sajax coming out here now? Dragon Mage for Kaibutz. I don't know if I can change over to Dragon Mage right now. We hadn't seen any dragons, or I don't have any dragons at least. We do have the shield that is on our Frost Knight. Warriors going crazy on us. That's okay though. I ain't done. Our Argali Knight actually dropped that sword for us. We're staying alive. We're still healthy. We got time. We'll try to get four Warlock, I think, but because I don't think really in this situation here, we'll take this Venom. In the situation here, with all these warriors, no mage on the lobby, oh man. Garfit, this was your game. This was your game to win, Garfit, with all these warriors. I don't think that us having Shaman is going to really beat Warrior, because there's not, like, warriors don't have, like, that carry besides Zerker and Sacred Lance, which still you can get around a little bit. So I think we'll go into the Warlocks and just go four Warlock, four Glacial, four Knights, and see if we get it online. We got Pete Dog going with the Feather and that Beast build. Has the Shadow Crawler on the backside and actually crit the you-know-what out of our Lightblade Knight, which is not good. Evil Knight, our Argali Knight trying to tank away. Our Soul Reaper gets the heal down, but it's not a full game. It gave it a try. Did they put you out? You're still alive? Oh, no. GG, though, Crow. GG. I'm going to, if you do it tonight on stream, man, you know we'll be there watching. All right, let's go ahead and do just that right there. We have to get this Lightblade to 3-star soon. Let's rearrange two a little bit here. No, we don't want him that far up. I want to see it, Crow. I'm not going to lie to you. I want to see it 4-4-4. Garu, yes. Cool build past 9 warrior meta, by the way. Wait, why are you living? Your LBK is still 2-stars. I know. Why am I leveling? Because I wanted to get into the 4 Warlocks, and then I'm going to roll like crazy, Garfix. We got some health. Actually, we got a little bit lower health now. We got taken away. 4-4-4. Which way are you talking for 4-4-4? You mean for me to go Urgisus, Garu? Go 4 Urgisus with this? 6 Warlock for Glacial is fun. That is an interesting idea there too, Opstra. If we can do it on a video game, I'll try it again, or you can try it. I would. Whoa! Sandal Co. 17. Sandal Co., man. Y'all, if you got some rosés, let's give them to Sandal Co. over here. Thank you so much for that follow, Sandal Co., and welcome to the family. If you got any questions or you need any... 4 Glacial, 4 Knights, 4 Warlocks. Perfect. That's what I was thinking about doing. That's what we are doing. So I appreciate that too there, Garu. Sandal Co., hello, Sandal Co. How are you doing today? Put it in chat if you ever need anything or you have any questions. If you lurk, you lurk away and have some fun. Thank you for that follow, Sandoko. How are you doing? How are you doing right now? We don't have any Troll Berserkers or Sacred Lancers yet either. All the warriors are taking them. That's okay. If we had those, it might be a little bit different. Got second with it. Having, I believe it, man. That sounds like it's a pretty good 6 Warlocks and 4 Glacials. Oh. That is a Holy Spirit Lance. That's going to be something I am going to try off. So that sounds pretty freaking dope, honestly. I know that was a pretty fat roll there. There we go. We're doing a little rolling there to try to get this Lightblade Knight. Our percentage isn't the best for it right now. Whoa! Leroy! Thank you so much for that follow as well, Leroy. And Jack and McSteezy and B and Crow, thank y'all for those rosés too for Sandals follow. Leroy, thank you for the follow as well. And welcome to the family, Leroy, if you need anything. Leroy Jenkins! Indeed. Welcome to the family, Leroy. You need anything as well, just let me know. Let anyone in the chat there know. The family, we take care of each other, man. Thank you so much, guys. Thank y'all. Thank you. Thank you. B, Jack, Crow, and McSteezy, thank y'all for those rosés again, too, man. Thank y'all for those rosés. Sandalco Garfit, I'm not Indonesian. There we go. All right. Yeah, Leroy and Sandalco, thank y'all for the follows. And also from earlier, too, guys. Pat, 92 Deeb, and Son of God. I think Son of God's already gone. I don't know if Pat's still out there. Thank y'all for the follows as well, man. It's been another amazing, amazing day. Y'all are too good to me. I hope you know that. There we go. So we're putting a Troll Berserker in, guys. Going to give us a little bit more damage here. And item-wise, holy moly. Not the best, but that is A-okay. There we go. GG. Wait. Did you go out, Stratega? I'm sorry. I was going crazy. GG is still in here. Stratega, did you go out, man? I might be going out right now against Pete Dog's Beast. We do have a pretty big Lightblade Knight who is actually shredding through, and we will survive this barely from Pete Dog. Foxy just went out there too. GG Foxy and GG Stratega. I misclicked Soul My Carry. Oh my gosh, Stratega. Foxy and Stratega, guys. Give them those GGs. If you mean the sandal part, yeah, I heard it before. I think it's a place somewhere in Indonesia. Yeah, thank y'all for the GGs on them too here. Everyone has played very, very well, guys. Like always, but still, I think we'll keep the Econ here and... Ooh, man. So empty-handed, because we're not the only ones. All right, so, guys, we need a Dark Spirit for our last Warlock, and we'll have 4 Warlocks. We're getting closer to 3-starring the Lightblade Knight, so we'll have to hold on to that. And B, McSteezy, Crowforge as well, and Stratega and Pete Dog, thank y'all for those GGs. They have definitely earned it. Everyone is playing great here. We have Laffy Taffy from Cave Clan Glacial Shaman going through us. This might put us out of the game right now. GG's pretty big. One health. Holy moly, one health. Misclick and put out the ninth warrior. Dang, Foxy. Everyone misclicking right now. Today, all luck, RNG only for Havocs. I'm in. Garfield was just trying to send it over to me to get me some ELO today. Is all that RNG was. I think I got to start one of these up. So, okay. We're about to 3-star Desperate Doctor. Not exactly the carry that we are looking for, guys. But, you know, we take what we can get here, right? We take what we can get here. All right. So, we trying to get a 3-star Lightblade Knight is what I'm digging for as we speak. Desperate Doctor is 3-star, guys. Oh, right before the round started. I don't know if this is going to do it right now. We got the Warriors against us. We are sitting in Dark Spirits pure damage, and Kaibutz is going to put us down right now as we speak. Sacred Lancer tries to carry us. Not enough, though. And we'll go out on 5th there. We got the top 5 of the top 4 right now. Wanted to try 6 Warriors, 6 Glacial. That's actually a good idea, Foxy. I haven't thought about that. And Stratega, Crow, McSteezy, and B, thank y'all for those GGs here, too. And those rosés, I got those rosés back for you. And actually, GG just went out as well. I don't know if GG is in the channel and can hear us, but GG, 2 GGs, guys, 2 GG. Yeah, GG. You're right there. Don't know if GG's in here, so I wanted to tell him GG as well. It is down to Kaibutz, Pete Dog, and Sajax, y'all. Just some monsters going on here. We are on Kaibutz, making sure... actually, we're not on Kaibutz. We're on Pete Dogville. Let's go to Kaibutz. Kaibutz is doing 9 warriors with the normal stuff peppered in. 2 Glacial, 2 Beast, and 2 Cave Clan on the back end there, too. Yeah, GG, Sajax's friend indeed, man. It's down to Sajax, Pete Dog, and Kaibutz. Monsters going on. 9 warriors over here for Kaibutz still. 2-star Sacred Lancer. Has an even 2-star Troll Berserker, but does have that 2-star Sacred Lancer on the board. And there is, I called it down for him. What does Sacred Lancer have? Sacred Lancer has an Infused Mask, a Claw Wand, and not a Holy Spirit Lance yet, but it's coming. All he needs is the Dragonblade Axe. I dropped one. Apparently it did not go to him, though. All right, it is Pete Dog versus Kaibutz right now. Kaibutz is against Pete Dog's copy. Pirate Ship goes back into the corner, does stun them. The Sacred Lancer for Kaibutz is just over here chopping away at the Warpwood. Everyone else, the trees are falling, and Whisper Seer as well. And Sacred Lance is just going line by line with Doom and Tusk and killing everybody like a just monster right here. On a winning streak. P-Dog and Sajax. Looks like they're still fighting. It might finish up before it loads in there, though. Oh, it is. It's Warpwood and Kung Fu Panda against a 2-star Pirate Captain and a 2-star Troll Berserker. Pirate Ship's coming down for the stun, and it is actually doing a pretty good bit of work, but he gets right back up, drops the heal. He has a Frost Armor, but I don't know that's going to be enough. Actually, it was not. No, it was not. And Sajax and Crow, thank y'all for those GGs as well there, too. I don't know if I said that, so I want to make sure I didn't miss it. Stay on Pete Dog. He is a little bit low on health. It is a battle right here. About to 3-star this War Sniper, guys. We had a 3-star Desperate Doctor on the bench and just fell a little short. Always a bridesmaid, never a bride. So don't push it, it'll go bad no matter what you think or I say. All right, Kaibutz versus Pete Dog. This is the real deal. There is no... Actually, Pete Dog is against Kaibutz's copy. All we're watching is copies here, guys. Dark Spirits ult go back on the entire upside of the map from both of their Dark Spirits. Sword spinning to win for Kaibutz Warriors, going straight through. Troll Berserker and Sacred Lancer are running amok. This Sacred Lancer right here, guys, is going crazy for Kaibutz. Ends up dropping Pete Dog. Pete Dog stays alive, though. And it looks like Kaibutz beat Sajax over here, too. It wasn't a big win, though. He didn't take a lot of health off of him. Strong, be strong. He is holding this Venomancer. Pete Dog, that is. I don't know what he's planning to do. Oh, he sold it. As soon as I called it out, he got rid of it. He's like, nope, no more Veno. Might have been something he was using before he got this Dark Spirit in. Dark Spirits can be better against the Warriors. It does that pure damage, that oil spill. The Whisper Seer does have a Teleport Dagger. He is tanking this Troll Berserker, the Abyssal Guard, and the Tusk, and does get taken down. Had the Shadow Crawler back there as well, but it bought the frontline time to clean it up. The Sacred Lancer has so much attack speed and damage. The Wind Ranger and Shining Archer go down in the oil spill, but Pete Dog's going to live and not go out there, but he's going to have to deal with Sajax next, I believe, guys. Ooh, Sajax's Ghost Kid is chopping away. This looks like a draw right here. All right, we're going to stay on Pete Dog. Kaibutz, the Sacred Lancer, is a complete monster. We got a 3-star Dwarf Sniper for Pete Dog now, though. 3-star Razor, 3-star Whisper, 3-star Warpwood, all the Druids besides that Unicorn. 3-star up over here. And has a Shadow Crawler instead of a Shining Assassin. He might have had problems finding Shining Assassin early. 2-star this. And just didn't worry about Shining Assassin. Don't say Jack's coming in hot with them Warriors right now. Warp Daddy, Razor Claw on the front line tanking. Whisper Seer teleports to the side. Starts tanking the, Flying Gazelles, man. What is going on? Thank you so much for that raid, Flying Gazelles. Drop some Rosés down. This is some more hype going on here. Coming in hot, baby. For Sigma, what is happening? Welcome everyone from Flying Gazelle's stream. And Flying Gazelle, how was the stream? How are you doing, man? Thank you so much. You are far too kind. And thank y'all for dropping them rosés down there too. Pete Dog, GG Pete Dog. Pete Dog just went down as well. GG to Pete Dogs, guys. Garu looking like that cool cat here. Stratega, McSteezy, B, and Crow, thank y'all for the rosés there. Give Flying Gazelle some love, guys. Click on the name. You see it in chat right there. Drop the follow button and show Gazelle some love for that raid. Was a good stream. Glad to see some new auto chess streamers around since I came back. Welcome back, Flying Gazelles. And thank you for that follow as well, Flying Gazelle. Pete Dog, thank you for the rosés too. Crow Forge for the GG. Flying Man, the way we do it, you need anything, you want to chat, man, just chat away. If you want to lurk away. Welcome to the family. Thank y'all for dropping some rosés down for me for that follow from Flying Gazelles as well. And y'all show him some love too for that raid. Thank you so much, man, for real. Thank you. We got a viewer lobby going on right now. We'll do another one after this too, guys, if we have enough people who still want to. It's down to Kaibutz and Sajax. It is the Battle of the Queens right here. Nine warriors against nine warriors is what's going on too. Both running nine warriors, both running hard in nine warriors. You're in Garfit, come on in, baby. You know I got room for you always, man. Always got room for you, Garfit. Flying, man, Flying Gazelles. Thank you again for that host, that raid. Here it is, warrior on warrior action right now. Kaibutz has the two-star Sacred Lance, but she is just kind of is she stunned right now? Yeah, she was stunned. Is getting the damage up, time up. I don't have a time up on the thing, but we've been going for about like 4.5 hours right now, Garu. About 4.5 hours we've been going for. I want to try build. This is the place to do it. The Sacred Lancer is dropping the spears with the Doom and takes him down there, baby. Yeah, P-Dog played really well, guys. If you haven't given him a GG yet, he deserves it. Uptime, there you go. Thank you, Sandalco. Yeah, I was about to say about 4.5 hours. A little bit short there. Is out of control. All right, we got it's once again, it's warriors on warriors. Kaibutz went open fort and has been going hard since then with these warriors. Got everything two-starred, basically full build right here. Still holding a Rogue Guard and another Sacred Lancer. Probably not going to get a 3-star there, but that's okay. He can still try. So Sajax against Kaibutz once again. Sacred Lancer on the bottom side, chopping away. Two pirate ships coming down, trying to turn the tides. There are Dark Spirits all everywhere on both teams. Don't know whose is whose right now. I think Kaibutz is the one that the Rogue Guard is standing in, and Sajax is the bottom one. Kaibutz's Lance, Dark Spirit, and Doom are still alive. Let's see how Sajax adjust to this here. Let's see what happens. There you go. Get some more points there, Garu. Get that money, baby. Here's what we can do too, guys. Here's what we can do too real fast. It only stays up for 30 seconds. I gotta update the timer on it. Go ahead and type join and try to get some points over there so you can have some fun. Warriors are going hard, Stratega. If you transition hard into warriors, they are still very strong, man. There is no doubt about that. All right, so Sajax has rotated, has a teleport dagger on his Rogue Guard to buff his Doom right now. Does a good bit of damage. Kaibutz's sword spin into one on the backside. Once again, Dark Spirit ults are down everywhere. Kaibutz's Sacred Lancer is a huge problem back there still, though. Rogue Guard is actually alive. The Abyssal Crawler and the Berserker also push through right now, and Sajax adjusts again. Like last game, Sajax has been a monster in here, guys. Sajax has been a monster in here. McSteezy and Garu won 2,500 each, baby. Congrats, congrats. Congrats, congrats, guys. So, Sajax last game, Dragon Mage against Insectoids from Garu. Another very, very good player. And Sajax adjusted the Dragon Mages and survived and won the game. He's adjusting again to Kaibutz. Let's see how Kaibutz answers this adjustment right here. Warriors on Warriors. Dark Spirit is on the back line for Kaibutz, getting double teamed by the Abyssal Guard and the other Dark Spirit. In the middle, though, the Warriors are holding. The Troll Berserker is trying to chop away at the Werewolf, but Sacred Lancer is starting to run amok again. Well, Abyssal Guard, though, is still alive, and this Dark Spirit is still alive. They are triple teaming the Sacred Lancer. Big Mama Raid Boss just got raided and goes down. I hope y'all have fun. Hopefully can catch you more often. Cheers. Cheers, Flying Gazelle. You take it easy, man. You take it easy. Hey, Thundy, we'll do one more raffle, guys. I have to up the time for more than 30 seconds. I can't do it right now, but I will raffle. Do another raffle here. Y'all go ahead and type exclamation point join. They only give you 30 seconds to get in, so do it while you can. Do it while you can. Sajax and Kaibutz in the attrition right now. This is the heavyweight championship rounds right here, guys. The fourth and fifth round is where we are at, going against the Glacial Cave Clan. Everyone's going to get one more option for an item to try to turn this around here and see who ends up winning. It's back and forth. We got a slobber knocker on our hands. There we go. Oh my gosh, multiple. Pete Dog, McSteezy, and Stratega pulling them points out right there. Jumping in head first in the last call. All right. This is it. Someone lives, someone dies here, guys. Sajax or Kaibutz, you can place your bets. It is down to it. We're in the final round of this championship fight. It's been back and forth. Tooth and nail, they've been clawing, fighting, scrapping. You're killing me, Thundy. All right, here we go. Kaibutz is Warriors. We are on Sajax's board. Any green units you see are Sajax's. Kaibutz is the red. Pirate ships are coming down on both ends. And actually, Sajax is turning it on Kaibutz. Sword of Spin to win. Kills him on the bottom. Sacred Lancer is by herself chopping away right now. Takes down the Abyssal. It's Sacred Lancer versus Berserker one-on-one right now. And it's not over yet, man. They are still living. This is still going, if you can believe it. I thought Sajax had completely collapsed on Kaibutz, and that Sacred Lance lived and pulled that round out barely. Holy cow, what a fight this is. What a fight. Sajax still rotating around. Kaibutz also probably looking around at stuff too here. I don't know which way this is going. This is the one of the greatest ends we've had, without a doubt. Without a doubt. I think I fell in love. I hope it's for the... All right, here we go again. We're on Kaibutz's board this time, guys. Pirate ship's coming down. Oil spill, sword spinning to win. Sacred Lancer has a Holy Spirit Lance now for Kaibutz, and she is cleaving through the front wave of Sajax here. Rogard is two-starred and still alive. He is about to take her down. He does, actually. It's Rogard versus Dark Spirit. I think Rogard wins it, guys. And Sajax clutches that out. What a freaking battle. GG, guys. Holy moly, man. GG to Sajax and to Kaibutz. What an absolute brawl that was. What an absolute brawl. Good game indeed, Sajax. Holy cow, guys. I don't even know what to say about that one. That was a classic, man. Yeah, that was great. They were rotating around. They were adjusting. They did it all. They did it all, man. Hey, M. Gruden, what's going on, Gruden? How are you doing, man? How is your Saturday going, Gruden?